Heath. And now we present the first episode of a new radio drama series, The Death of Mary, Queen of Scots. Part 1, The Beginning.
You are Mary, Queen of Scots?
I am.
Mary, Queen of Scots.
Episode 2 of The Death of Mary, Queen of Scots can be heard on Radio 4 almost immediately.
She's dead.
No, I'm not.
That was episode 2 of The Death of Mary, Queen of Scots, adapted for the radio by Bernard Hollowood and Brian London. And now, Radio 4 will explode.
Oh dear, the radio's exploded.
Oh, well, what's on the television then?
Looks like a penguin.
Now, I didn't mean what was on the TV set. I meant what program?
Oh, well, I'll switch it on.
Tall and tender and young and lovely. Now go home and be my
It's odd that penguin man there, isn't it? What's he doing there?
Standing.
I can see that.
If it laid an egg, it will fall down the back of the television set.
We'll have to watch that. Unless it's a male.
I hadn't thought of that.
It looks fairly butch.
Perhaps it's from next door.
Next door? Penguins don't come from next door. They come from the Antarctic.
Burma?
Why did you say Burma?
I panicked.
Perhaps it's from the zoo.
Which zoo?
How should I know which zoo? I'm not Dr. Bloody Bronowski.
How would Dr. Bronowski know which zoo it was from?
He knows everything.
Oh, I wouldn't like that. That would take all the mystery out of life. Anyway, if it was from the zoo, it'd have property of the zoo stamped on it.
No, it wouldn't. They don't stamp animals property of the zoo. You can't stamp a huge lion.
They stamp them when they're small.
What happens when they molt?
Lions don't molt?
No, but penguins do. There! I run rings round you logically.
Oh! Intercourse the penguin!
Hello. Well, it's just after 8 o'clock and time for the penguin on top of your television set to explode.
How did he know that was going to happen?
It was an inspired guess. And now...
Number 23... Reginald Maudling's Shin. Number 25, Nipple. Number 26, Reginald Maudling's elbow.